vestibule of the Archive New South Wales. For those who frequent the gallery, the space is looking very different to how it would normally do so. This installation is by artist Karla Dickens, who's an Australian artist. It's called a Dickensian circus. It's made up of lots of different elements. Firstly, here we have these kind of figures. They're kind of rendered in these really gnarled kind of materials, which contrast a lot with, you know, the smooth Sydney sandstone of this location. Dickens described these kind of cage structures as comprising a human zoo. And she talks about the way that it connects to the large numbers of Aboriginal women who were held in camps and incarceration centres around the country. Elsewhere in this space, on the other side, we have these boxing glove structures. So these pertain to quite a specific Australian history and Aboriginal experience. During the 20s, 30s, all the way up until the 50s, and even in many cases today, lots of Aboriginal men kind of participated in these boxing troops, which would move around the country. So the boxing glove, kind of raised fist, speaks to their resilience. Resilience in the face of adversity. What else is in this room? On either side of the vestibule, kind of flanking on both sides, we have an Aboriginal man, and on the other side, Aboriginal women. You'll notice they're both staring directly into the camera. Dickens is very careful to present these people in ways that, you know, spoke to the diversity of their experiences, but at the same time left them with a sense of autonomy when people look at these images. And lastly, you'll see these buckets here. They relate to children's kind of fable, There's a Hole in My Bucket, which describes a situation which the past keeps on occurring. So there's a hole in the bucket, fill it with water, and the water will continue to leak through the bucket. And again, it's in response to the disproportionate number of Aboriginal people in incarceration around the world. It speaks to systemic kind of instabilities and injustices.